Hey everyone, my name is Kelvin, and welcome to my channel. So today we're going to do some front-end stuff, and I found this website called Dev Challenges from Dev2, the blog. And I looked through some of the challenges, and the one that I want to do today is the GitHub Jobs Challenge. Now this is going to use the GitHub Jobs API here, and we could go ahead and open it up in another tab to see the documentation. But there is a small problem, so let's say we grab this URL endpoint and try it in the browser here, and we'll just console log the response. So you'll see that this doesn't work because it's being blocked by cores, and that's why we're going to be using Next.js, so we can use the server side of it as somewhat of a reverse proxy, so we can get around the cores issue. So let's go ahead and create a new Next.js app, and you can use create next app with either yarn or npm, and I guess I'll just call it next jobs. So once that's done, you'll have a new repo for a Next.js app, except it's in JavaScript. So Next.js makes it really easy to just add TypeScript. So all we have to do here is add an empty tsconfig.json file, and then install TypeScript as well as the types for React and Node. And since this project is going to be using the API routes because we have to do some server-side stuff, I'm going to also add the types for Node. And then lastly, once we open it up, we just have to rename all the JS files to TypeScript files. And then remember, every JS file that has JSX in it, we have to rename with the TSX file extension. Now, it'll error out right now because we don't have anything inside of our tsconfig. That is until we run yarn dev for the first time. And Next.js will take care of the TypeScript configuration for us. So you can exit out of the process and then look inside, and our tsconfig is now populated with some compiler options for us. Now before we get started on the code, let's go back to the Dev Challenges website, and then you go ahead and download the resources here, which will give you a zip file. And I'm also going to open up the Figma design mockups, which is super helpful because I suck at design, so I'm glad that someone has already done it. So I just transformed this to CSS, which is also the main reason why I decided to do this challenge, but yeah. Now once we get the assets, we're going to make sure that we're going to put it inside the public directory here. And I added it inside of a folder called assets, and these are going to be the images that we need for our application. Now I don't think Vim could actually, yeah. So let's not open it up inside of Vim because this is kind of a mess. Instead, I'll just use Ranger to go into the public and assets so that we can see these images. So there's the background hero image. I don't think we're actually going to use this dev challenge icon thing. And then there's also the scarecrow, which I should probably explain. So on top of doing the GitHub jobs challenge, I decided that we could do the 404 responsive challenge as well, just to knock two birds out with one stone. And besides, this application is going to need a 404 page anyways, so might as well. But yeah, that's where the scarecrow comes from. So that solves the image problem. And now if we go into the Figma thing and start clicking around on stuff, there'll be information on the right-hand side, such as the color, as well as the font. So we could add this to our project global style sheet as some variables. And first, we're gonna need to go to Google Fonts and add some of those. So the first one I know is Poppins. And I'm only gonna show this one because I'll just paste in the rest. But here, we're gonna be using mostly just the regular font as well as the bold. So those are the two that we're gonna select. And then on the right hand side, we're gonna call on the import, which you could highlight and copy from inside the style tags here. Take the fonts that we need and add it to our global style sheet. Let's open up styles. We don't need this one, so I can get rid of that. And inside of globals, let's just add a bunch of stuff on the top. So first, these are the four fonts that we're gonna be using. It's gonna be Poppins, Montserrat, Roboto, and Space Mono. Next, we'll make a root where we can store all of our CSS variables for colors. And these are the ones that I think are necessary. So once again, you get the actual hex codes from the Figma source, but I've named it as text, gray, black, background, and link. And we could already go ahead and use it because the body is gonna have the background color of BG, and then the text color of text everywhere. Now lastly, before we leave this global CSS file, I'm just going to add a reset to all of the headings so that we have font size and font weight to be a little more predictable while we play with them. And maybe we'll come back to this file, but I think that's good for now. And lastly, I need to go into home and get rid of everything inside this return. So we have a good starting point of saying homepage works. We can also get rid of these two since they're no longer being used. And next, let's set up our API stuff. So I'm gonna make another directory called lib, and let's put an API file inside that. I meant to make an API file, not directory. So the first thing that we know is the API URL, which is job.github.com/positions. And we're leaving off the .json here, because if we go to the documentation, for a specific one where we need the ID, the .json comes after the ID instead of on the positions subroute parameter thing. Now we can also open up the endpoint itself in a new tab, and we could get all this stuff, which this is not super helpful because I can barely read it. But I'm going to go use QuickType, which is a tool that we can generate some TypeScript interfaces, and ideally I think there's only one. So this is going to be the TypeScript interface that we need. And also it's a bit more pretty printed here, so you can see that we'll get a UUID as the ID, a URL, we have the full-time, part-time as a type, the company name and the logo. And the really interesting part here is that description and how to apply. We have HTML in here. So that'll be something that we'll have to tackle in a little bit later down the road. Now we can go ahead and paste that type in. So we have the interface of GitHub job. So I think that's all we need for this file. I think the next thing we need to do is change the API route. So I'm going to change this from hello to index.ts. There we go. And let's change this up a little bit. Let's grab the request and response type from Express, because that's what these two are. And I'm also going to change this to async, because we're going to do a fetch here, which I will also add a try catch block so we could with an error appropriately. Well, let's grab the API URL that we've hard coded in the API file, do an asynchronous fetch on that. And because this is the fetch API, we also need to await the JSON decoding. And if that's successful, we could respond from this API route with a status of 200 and the body of the JSON. And I guess request isn't being used, so we'll just change this to an underscore. Cannot find module express. I'm pretty sure I installed the types. Oh, I did not. All right, well, I'm gonna install them now. Okay, that's better. All right, now let's go ahead into our index page, and we're gonna import useEffect for this, so that we could do a fetch on mount to the API route that we just created. And since React useEffect can't take an async function, we'll just use promises here. And right now, let's just console log out the response. So ideally, when we start up the page, this should respond to us without a CORS error. So let's just do a yarn dev to start up our application, and then open it up on localhost 3000. And there's our homepage works. So we need a lot to do before this starts looking a lot better. But we can go ahead and inspect, and we do get an array of 50 jobs back. And if we open up these objects, you can definitely tell these are GitHub jobs. So we've successfully set up the API route. And then back in our app, I know we just set this up, but it was mostly just to check if our API route was working. We're gonna actually get rid of this, and instead we're gonna create a function called get server side props, so we can get all the data on the server side before the page is rendered, and basically do the same fetching mechanism that we already set up in our API route. And what we need to do is return an object that looks like this. So it has to have props inside of it, and this is basically the server side props. And then I'm gonna add jobs as JSON, being what we get back from the fetch. And then if we get an error, I'll just do an empty array. And let's not forget to grab the API URL. Okay, so now that we got the server-side props, we need to get it inside of the home. And we can do that by props here. And just to make our lives easier, let's make sure that we define the types for this component. So our home props, jobs property is gonna be a GitHub jobs array. Now we can do this so that the typing is enforced. Alright, so that's the initial setup for our homepage. Okay, that's been 10 minutes. I am now deciding that this is a video series, where this video is just mainly set up. There's one last thing that I want to set up, and that's going to be the layout. And by layout, I mean just the outer rim here, this brand, and also this footer. And maybe we'll also do the 404 page, because it's not overly complex. So we're going to open up our file explorer, make a new directory called components, and I'm going to do a module style file structure, so everything that has to do with layout is going to be inside of layout and exported through the index.ts file. The first component being the layout.tsx, and inside of our layout.tsx file, let's import the head from nextHead, and this will let us write to the head property of our HTML document outside of the body, where we're going to have the title. And every page is going to have the title of GitHub Jobs, but we're also going to have an individual page title, which we're going to put inside props so we can render it dynamically here. But now that we've added props, let's make sure that we create an interface for our props so that we know that title is required whenever we use this. And also with layout, we're going to want the children prop. So we can just write normal JSX inside of the main HTML tag here. And I also want the header. We have that little H1 branding where it says GitHub Jobs. Now going back to the mockup, you'll see that GitHub is bold and the jobs isn't. To achieve that, we're gonna wrap the GitHub part in a span, so it'll look a little bit like this. And then lastly, we need a footer, so we can add that little text at the bottom where you can put your name, at, and then devchallenges.io. Alright, so now we just need CSS, so let's make another file called layout.module.css, and that's because we're gonna be using CSS modules, which is kind of my preferred method of doing CSS in React projects. And then one last thing before we add some classes, and that's I'm gonna add a div here to just wrap everything because we're gonna want a container class. All right, so let's open up the module CSS and let's also make sure that we have our React component on the side so we could just add classes when we need them. So let's start with the container. I'm gonna make sure that it has a width of 90% and center it with the margin. All right, next, let's add a class for our header. And we can go ahead and just click on the header and get all the information on the side. But the important part is that it's gonna be using the Poppins font. And I'm approximating, but this is gonna be 1.5 rem here. Next is I'm just gonna make sure that the color is black and we give it some spacing with the margin. Now we don't want that span of bold, so I'll do that in a class called header brand. And because there's a hyphen here, since I wanna write idiomatic CSS, when I say idiomatic, I just mean like CSS that feels right. So instead of accessing the property with a dot, we're gonna use the square brackets so we could add a string with a hyphen. Now, let's also make css.main here. The only thing I want in the main container, or the main tag, is to have a minimum height of 70% view height. This is kind of just like on a field basis, but I don't want the footer to be too high on the page. Speaking of footer, we'll add a class for that as well. And I don't think you really need to see me like go back and forth with the mock, so I'm just gonna add the styles here. But this is going to be the font of Montserrat with 600 font weight, gray, and a little bit of margin on the bottom. And don't forget to also add the class name. But with that, our header is complete. The only thing we need to do is add it to our index page. So that's where we can just change this div to layout and give it a home as the title. Is not a module. Oh, I forgot to export from index, so we need to do that. So star from dot slash layout, and that'll fix that. And we're still getting one because we're not using props, but we'll get to that in a little bit. But we can test this out by going back to the browser, and there's our little layout. We have appropriate spacing on the sides, our footer, and our header, as well as the page title that we've set on the head property. Yeah, let's go ahead and make a not found page. So to do that in Next.js, you just need to make a 404.tsx file inside of the pages directory. And it doesn't matter what you name the component, but Next.js will be smart enough to know that this file is the not found, regardless of the path. Now let's go into the mockup of the not found page. And since this is technically a different project, it might not match the layout that we have, like so the header and everything. So we can't really reuse the same layout that we created. So I'm gonna make another layout called the not found layout. Now we could reuse some things, so I could just go into the normal layout and copy most of this and change things up as we need it. So I'm gonna add it inside this fragment. And first, let's import the things from Next. And we can get rid of the prop stuff. So no title and no children. And then the biggest difference is everything inside of this main. So first we're going to add the scarecrow image. And we're going to be using the next image component. So we'll import image from next image, which will take a direct path to scarecrow.png. And remember, assets is coming from the public folder. And that's what the root path is hitting. Now with the next image component, we need to define both width and height. And these are the dimensions of the image file. So it's 655 pixels by 395. And I only know that because I opened up the image and looked at it. So next, we just need to add the text. So the whole, I have a bad news for you, and this, and also to this button. And I'll put it all inside the div because we're gonna make sure this main is going to display flex. And then lastly, before the button, we're gonna wrap it in a next link, which needs a href, and we're just gonna hit slash, so it goes straight to the homepage. I believe that's all we need to do. But let's reopen up the layout module and add some classes. So to make sure that this is different from main, I'll have a not found class. Even though it's gonna share the min height from main, it'll be different because we're gonna use space mono as the font here, and we're gonna display this as flex. And of course, we need to add this CSS class here. Now let's style the h2 inside of not found, which is gonna be bold and it's gonna be huge. So this will be 4rem as a font size with the color of black. Now this is the variable black and not straight black. So it's kind of important to note. Let's also do the paragraph, which the only notable thing is this is gonna be a font size of 1.5rem. And then finally, we need to do the back button. Let's make sure that it matches the colors of the font. So the background color is black and the normal color is white, or I mean the text color. We'll give it 1.5rem and 3rem padding so it has that button feeling. Text transform uppercase here so that it's part of the style and not part of the text inside of the button. So this is back button. And I believe that's all we need to check out our thing. So we just need to make sure that we go to a route that doesn't exist. And luckily, nothing exists. There's a problem. Oh, that's because we're not using this yet. So first, let's make sure that we export everything from not found and then import it in our 404 page. So we use the not found layout inside of our not found page. And that's pretty much it. So there it is. The only thing that we need to check is that if we click on the button, this will take us back to home, which it doesn't click. Oh, I know why. The server-side rendering is taking a amount of time, so it's kind of slow. That's fine. So the button works. I was just kind of impatient. So that's it for this video. In the next video, we're actually going to do the job pages. So all these cards here, as well as probably this entire page for the individual jobs. But until then, we have a good basis for our starting point. And I hope you enjoyed this video, and I'll see you all next time.